Hello, my name is Joe Prusa and I'm the creator of the Prusa i3. We appreciate all of you who selected the original Prusa Mark IV as your new 3D printer. And today I will guide you through the very first print of your new 3D printer. So let's get started. Once you flick the switch on the power supply, the printer will boot up and greet you with an installation wizard. So let's confirm it. Now the printer is telling you that it will start the self-test. Whether you've put the printer together yourself or received it fully assembled, the printer will go through a series of checks just to make sure everything is working correctly or that, for example, something important didn't get loose during the shipping. So let's start it. First, it will test the fans. You might be able to hear that in a second. It gradually ramps up their speeds and it checks if the measured RPMs are correct. Both fans are good. Next is the load cell test. The load cell sensor is embedded in the heatsink and it is used for automatic first layer calibration before each print. We'll see it in action soon once we start the print. But right now, the printer is telling us that we will need to tap the nozzle. It is cold, so you don't have to worry about burning yourself. And if the nozzle was hot, the wizard would wait for it to cool down before letting you proceed. Once you click continue, there is a 5-second countdown. And once it counts down, you just need to tap the nozzle. And our load cell is okay. Right away, the printer will start the next test. It starts by testing the x-axis, then it moves the heat bed and tests the y-axis. And lastly, the z-axis is tested. X-axis is okay. Now the y-axis. And lastly, the Z-axis. Next up, the printer will test both the heater in the printhead and the heat bed at the same time. You can already see the temperatures at the bottom of the screen. We can see that the nozzle heater already passed successfully. And now we'll wait a few seconds and the heat bed test pass as well. Next up is the filament sensor calibration. This is super easy. We just need a piece of filament. In the next step, the printer asks if there is a filament loaded. In our case, yes. So we click unload. But if you don't have filament loaded, just press continue. We just select that it's PLA. That is what we ship the printer split. As you can see, the extruder is heating up, so we can safely unload the filament. So now we just take the filament out. The filament sensor now calibrates its state without the filament inserted. We are now asked to insert the filament to finish the calibration. And that's it. It's working correctly. Oop. So the self-test is finished. You can scroll through a list of the checks. We passed all of them successfully. If there is a problem in some part of the self-test, you can repeat just that step. You don't have to go through all of them again. If there is some kind of an error, the printer will show you a QR code, which will take you to the troubleshooting guide. You'll find all of them at help.prusa3d.com. In case the guide isn't enough to fix your problem, feel free to reach out to our excellent support. The fastest way usually is to use 24/7 live chat, which you'll find on our eShop. Before you start your first print, you need to insert the filament into the extruder first. Simply put the start of the filament into the extruder and the autoload function will start the whole process. We just select the PLA, which is the filament P bundle. And we can see that filament is loaded, so we just confirm it. We are now almost ready to start the first print, but just before that, we need to clean the bed, just to be sure. We use the IPA. And we also need the included flash drive. And when we plug it into the printer, the test models are loading. We will choose, and we will choose the keychain PLA Mark IV, 16 minutes. And from now on, the printer will do everything by itself. Awesome. The first print just finished. The best way to take it down is to wait for it to cool down. Take the sheet off and do it. Yeah, wonderful. That's it for today's video. See you in the next one and happy printing.